Today, we want to have a look at the xtool D1 laser engraver. xtool has sent me this laser engraver for free in exchange for reviewing it and sharing my opinion. We want to look at this laser along four dimensions and compare it with the K40 CO2 laser. The four dimensions are structure and safety, cutting and engraving capabilities, software, and finally the price. We will always look at two different versions of the K40 and the xtool. The one version is how that product comes out of the box, and the other one is how you could enhance it with either DIY methods or by buying additional products. Let's start with structure and safety. The mechanical stability and precision of the xtool D1 is really nice. It seems to be a well-designed and stable product. Also for the K40 laser cutter, I don't have anything to complain about after running it now for quite some time. It is still very precise and doesn't show any signs of run out. The safety of the K40 when it comes out of the box is a big mess. I have documented that in earlier videos. However, if you are not afraid to solder and hack together a few solutions, the safety issues of the CO2 laser can easily be fixed for a small amount of money. I could not find any major safety issue with the xtool D1 laser engraver. There is, however, a general concern to run a laser engraver with no enclosure. xtool themselves does not offer an enclosure for that machine. You could, however, build an enclosure out of plywood and acrylic. As I haven't built an enclosure and there are no market products, I don't want to consider this extension. The enclosure of the K40 is fine. It does not offer an airtight seal, but other than that, it does its job. As said before, the xtool D1 does not offer an enclosure. If we look at the bed size of the two machines, the K40 comes with a bed size of roughly 300 by 200 millimeters, and the xtool has a bed size of nearly double that size with 400 by 400 millimeters. The large size in comparison with the portability gives you plenty of options to position the xtool D1 on top of a workpiece, for example, to engrave a table. Talking about the bed of the K40 out of the box is unusable and you will have to invest a few bucks in order to build a well-working honeycomb bed. The xtool does not come with any kind of bed, but you can easily throw a sheet of honeycomb, aluminium or steel on the table and use that as a bed. I would advise you put a piece of sheet steel below the honeycomb bed to protect your working surface, or in my case, the floor. The K40 uses switches as end stops and is thereby able to very repeatably find its zero position. The xtool does also support homing the machine, but does not use any end stops, but rather relies on the mechanical stop of the machine. This tends to be less precise than using a switch as an end stop. The height adjustment and focus of the K40 out of the box is bad, but you could easily improve that with a homemade bed. The xtool has a very nice adjustment functionality that allows you to position the laser in the correct height above the work surface. My version of the xtool comes with the rotary attachment that works really nice. There are third-party rotary attachments for the K40 in the range of 50 to 100 euros, but as I haven't tested those, I don't want to include them in the comparison. Out of the box, both machines don't have an air assist. For the K40, I created a simple DIY solution that will cost you around 10 euros. The air assist kit from xtool retails at a little more than 100 euros. From my point of view, having an air assist is a must-have feature for a laser if you are looking for clean cuts. The last criteria we want to look at regarding the structure is ventilation and exhaust. The K40 comes with a reasonably well working exhaust solution that can be further improved with a filter. Due to the lack of an enclosure, the xtool D1 can't offer any kind of exhaust, so the fumes will spread across your workshop. Let's now look at the cutting and engraving capabilities. Both machines are able to cut plywood, MDF and similar materials. While the K40 can cut colored and transparent acrylic, by design, a diode laser such as the xtool D1 is not able to cut transparent acrylic sheets. For the same cut, the K40 in 3mm MDF is running at 5mm per second. The xtool takes roughly the same time running at 6mm per second. Engravings are very fine and precise with the xtool. The level of detail is quite a bit better when compared to the K40 laser. Let's talk about the software. The K40 software that is delivered with the machine is basically not usable. However, there are great open source solutions, in particular K40 Whisperer, that offers all the bells and whistles you could ever dream of. If you are using Linux, the xtool is not usable for you. I was not able to update the firmware under Linux, and without a firmware update, you can't use Lightburn. At first, I understood from xtool that they are using GRBL as an open source software foundation and refused the review because they were not complying with the GPL. In the meantime, they told me that they are not using GRBL but have implemented themselves a compatible solution. While it is great that they are not violating the GPL, unfortunately their compatibility is limited to Lightburn. Other free laser cutting solutions such as LaserWeb are not able to work with that laser. The LaserBox basic software that comes with the machine is really very basic and is missing quite a few features that I find important for laser cutting. In particular, having only one layer and not the possibility to cut separate layers one after another is a very limiting factor. As with all proprietary Windows software solutions, there is always the question if the software is going to run under all future versions of Microsoft Windows. If you want to do simple engravings or simple cutting operations, the LaserBox basic version should be sufficient. Otherwise, you can use Lightburn, which will come at a license cost of around 60 euros. A very nice feature of the xtool is that after giving the machine access to your wireless network, you can also send engravings over the iOS or Android app. This is obviously an option that the K40 doesn't offer. Price and summary. Let's summarize the strengths and weaknesses of the two laser cutters. If you do not want to solder and you do not want to modify your laser, the xtool is the better starting point. You, however, have to feel comfortable using a laser with no enclosure, which is a safety risk. Especially for large-scale engravings or when you want to put the laser on top of the object you want to engrave, the xtool D1 is a viable solution. If you want to mainly focus on engravings and don't plan more complex cutting operations, the LaserBox basic software and the smartphone app should be able to fulfill most of your needs. Otherwise, you have to purchase light burn, and you can really use all the professional features one could expect from a laser cutting software. You should, however, keep in mind that when adding an air assist, the light burn license fee, and potentially an additional enclosure, you will end up with a price tag that is a fair bit higher than what you would have paid for a K40 based solution. I hope this review was helpful for you. If you have further questions, feel free to leave them below in the comment section.